Welcome back to the Mass Music Morning Show. This is Shlomo Bowe. I am joined in the studio by DJ Famous Sheamus.
Yes, sir.
Jimmy from the Q.
How you doing?
And Nazz.
What's happening?
What's up, brother? All right, listen. So I wanted to know what you guys would have as your personal theme song. I've been watching a lot of WWE lately. And when people walk out into the ring, you know, the crowd goes nuts. Obviously, the superstar, they go nuts. What would you choose as your theme song?
I mean, this is an age-old question, and I feel like many age-old questions, you can't rush into an answer. However, that is exactly what I did with this question. The first song that pops into mind is Sir Psycho Sexy by the Red Hot Chili Peppers.
Ooh, I had a feeling you were going to say that.
That's a goodie.
I recently came across it. I'd never heard it until about, probably 2 months ago?
Yeah.
And immediately I knew. I was like, this is it. You know what I mean? I would just be like a bad boy in WWE walking out. Whole crowd boos me. And this song just, you know, like you said, comes raining down from the heavens. So I think, you know, when we're thinking about these personal theme songs, they got to make you feel like a don.
Oh, yeah.
And I literally feel like Ric Flair or, you know, any gangster that you can think about. That's who I'm feeling.
I will say, too, it's important to note that the Spotify Year in Review just came out. Sheamus is in the 1% of listeners for Red Hot Chili
Incorrect.
Peppers.
Incorrect. I'm in the top 0.1%.
Oh, my God.
Of Red Hot Chili Peppers.
You're a Red Hot Chili simp.
I'm a Red Hot Chili Pepper.
He is a pepper.
If you said any others besides Red Hot Chili Peppers, I wouldn't have taken it seriously.
You know what I mean? Yeah. No, but Red Hot Chili Peppers, I'm 0.1%, dude. It's been a year, I will say. But what are you guys thinking for your personal theme songs?
For me, I think I categorize like a walk-up, walk-out song and your own theme song in two different categories. Yeah. So one decision's like very easy, and this is the easiest one I've had probably in any time I've been on this show.
Yeah.
Your Love by the Outfield. The late Tony Lewis just absolutely puts on a show, but it just... I don't know. I'm a high maintenance guy. I'm a pump up guy. Like that gets me going. Looking to run through a wall. I mean, whenever this song comes on, I think of, I guess, the late Patriot, Tom Brady coming on throwing touchdown passes.
Hell,
that's
yeah.
The one that comes on late fourth quarter.
That video it surfaced rather recently, and I wish it didn't because that song was stuck in my head for about 3 weeks, and I would just remix it. It'd be like, Scooby's on a vacation far away. And just
such
like, it would get stuck, man.
I don't want to lose your love
tonight. Absolute
heat. Five and a half right there.
I will say, I don't want to make this all about me. I want to make this about the late Tony Lewis, but I think he died like a month back ago.
Mm-hmm.
And one of my close friends texted me. He's like, I know this is a tough day for you. We will get past this. And I was just like, damn,
nice,
this might be my theme song. I think it is.
Yeah, I think so. I think it might have chosen you.
Yeah, exactly.
That's the best part about it. Well, Versace, I know you're a WWE guy. You're an electric type of individual, a don, a man of the streets, if you will.
Yep.
I know a guy like you needs the perfect theme song. You know what I mean? And there's a lot of songs I know that you're probably looking at, but... What's ringing around in there? What do you think is the one?
I'm stuck on two, and number one, I've actually used this song before at my only quote-unquote professional wrestling match I've had in your in your backyard on July 3rd.
That was a good
song. Do you guys remember the song I used?
I was front row and blackout drunk at the time. I don't remember.
It also, you know what? I was the DJ / referee, and I also don't remember.
I also had the man on my shirt too.
Is it "I'm a Boss" by Rick Ross?
It was. That would have been a good choice.
A good one,
but it was on my shirt. I had a Star Spangled Banner Jimi Hendrix shirt.
Oh.
And I came out to Voodoo Child.
Hell yeah!
And like it was a slow build. I came out and just like air guitar it, freaking getting the crowd pumped up, and so that was. That to me was a really good entrance theme. I feel like for this question, like you think of like entering an arena to this song, but also like what are the theatrics you get for your entrance? Like I'd definitely need pyro, flames.
Yeah.
I also like
fog machine too.
Fog machine, golden confetti. Like I would like to do it to the nines. My second song though, this is in my head. When like when I'm walking down the street or when I'm approaching to go to the party and Staying Alive by the Bee Gees.
Oh, hell yeah. When you're strutting.
That is a strut song. I feel like you can't sit down and listen to that song.
Oh, no.
It's one of those songs where as soon as you hear it,
you gotta walk. Yeah, you gotta walk somewhere.
Yeah, you're not just sitting down playing video games, drinking your morning coffee. You're, running through a wall, probably gonna run, looking to do something to prove the day wrong,
Honestly, I would pay any amount of money to be in the studio when he walked up to the mic and goes, "Hey, you can't tell by the way I use my walk, I'm a woman's man. No time to talk." I would have been like floored.
That would be amazing. So what are you thinking though?
Now, this song, like James said, it's gonna get a rise from the crowd. I would go with Return of the Mac, Mark Morrison. Because no matter what, from a child till probably I'm an old man, that song will get me going. Like no matter where I am, what I'm doing, I hear Return of the Mac, I'm getting busy, bro. I love it. And you said there would have to be theatrics to it. I'd walk out with a t-shirt gun, pew, pew, shooting hoodies up to the balcony. Yeah, it would just be fantastic. Return of the Mac.
Return of the Mac is amazing. I think, I don't know, just like thinking about like how legendary that song is, it reminds me of not the same genre, mm-hmm. but an equally as legendary song, and that is Strike It Up. I forget who it's by. Yeah.
Black Box, I think.
Is it Black Box?
Yeah.
Let's see. Black Box. Oh my god. I remember that one night in the studio.
Oh my goodness, the infamous night.
I was DJing and I dropped that song, and it might as well have been the Madison Square Garden in this room.
Yeah.
It was insane.
The vibes were exceptional that night.
Yeah, so that's another entrance song where I feel like it's for me, but I like, to amplify the room when I walk in. So I think that's part of the reason I'd choose this song. It's everyone else at the same time.
That's something I think of, like, really in this question where you can ask, like, almost anyone this question. And if it's not a song that's, like, expressive or action-y, like, what kind of person are you? Like, are you just mellow, sitting on the couch all day? Like, I don't know. You want to be live-like and everything like that.
Exactly.
All of our selections were kind of like relatively older songs.
Yeah.
Can we think of like a newer song?
That's a good point. That's a really good point. How recent though would you say is newer? Like
in the
after 2000?
In the last 10-15 years.
So my backup would be probably came up like 7 years ago. Wiz Khalifa's Real Estate.
That's a good one.
Hell yeah!
I don't think I know that one.
Like, if they want to know my name, they look up and see the game. I don't remember.
No. He had a lot of bangers though. Black and yellow.
What am I? Oh, that's a tough one.
Recent.
I feel it's really tough to answer that question. I'm thinking about Drake. It's gonna have to be a Drake song, right?
Something
you know what I mean? I don't know which one I'd choose.
When I'm around these parts, I like who you know, Cousin Stiz.
That's a really good one. Yeah. I actually have mine now. I'm gonna go with Santorini, Greece by Rick Ross.
Oh,
that is the fat man's anthem.
That's a great song.
And I fucking love that song. Love that song. It makes me cry every single time. So Santorini, Greece, that's what I'm going with.
Was that fat Rick Ross or fit Rick Ross?
Yeah, it was pretty fit Rick Ross. But as a large man myself, it gets us all going. Big fellas everywhere, worldwide, they get going when they hear that song.
Hell yeah.
I will say.
Hell yeah.
That's awesome.
But yeah, I think, that's probably the most recent anthem that I can think of. That I would even allow to be entered into that conversation.
There's so many. Ric Flair drip just walking out to that one with fire.
Yeah.
Damn. Well, hey, if you guys have any theme songs out there that you know would get a rise from the crowd, let us know in the comments. Hit us up. Slide in the DMs. But I hope you guys have a wonderful, wonderful day. Stay blessed. Peace.
This is Antonio Acquelli.
This is the one and only JQ from the Heels Turn Podcast.
This is Jimmy from the Q.
And you're listening to Mass Music Radio.
And you're listening to Mass Music Radio.
Mass Music Radio.